So you can buy different sizes of these spin-lock dumbbells, different length. So you can, if this runs, you get so strong on this that you need to upgrade. It's not a problem, since you just buy a different longer dumbbell. Like this can hold in maximum 40 kilos, as you can see. This can hold 60 kilos. And this can hold, I guess this can hold 80 kilos. Or, I haven't maxed out this, so I don't use that so often, but I use this pretty often, and this can hold 60 kilos. So, you just always buy longer one if you ran out of space. So they are kind of limitless. So, by changing the weights you put on it, you can change the profile of the dumbbell. If you use this kind of weights, the profile of the dumbbell changes. You use these are 10 kilos, these are 20 kilos. If the profile of the dumbbell changes like this. Now here, 5, smaller, and 2.5, it's even smaller. Like the benefit of this is that since the profile here, like the some of the dumbbells that are competing with the spin-lock dumbbells, you cannot change the weight you load on them. There is a couple of problems with that. And the first, which I will say now, is that you cannot change the profile of the dumbbell. Like, if you would like the profile to be thinner from to the sides, for doing some exercises where you are bringing the dumbbell on your side, like, for example, doing this, or doing bicep curls, you might want it to be leaner, so that it doesn't hit your sides, your legs, or that's your waist, or something. So, if you have some other type of adjustable dumbbells, you cannot change the weight they use. So, you are stuck with the profile. But with the spin-lock dumbbells, you are not. You can use whatever plates you have or buy on them. Like so. And here, if you want the profile for some reason to be thicker, you just put thicker plates. Okay, the second issue, what comes from not being able to change the profile of the weights, or the weights themselves, comes with that you cannot, if you would like to load the dumbbell with heavier weights, if you just have one set of spin-lock dumbbells, but you happen to have other types of plates, like, say, so, like if you use these with your straight bar, for example, you might want to use them on your dumbbells, since you have them, and they fit the dumbbell. So you can do it with the spin-lock dumbbells, since they have the same hole size. But with some other types of adjustable dumbbells, you can't, because they don't work like that. So you win also with that in that regard with the spin-lock dumbbells, because you can just use whatever plates you have and make it just heavier. Like for example, this is 22.5 kilo dumbbell. This is also, like, look at the side profile. It's pretty thick here. Okay, this is also 22.5 kilo dumbbell. It's lots leaner because it uses like lighter plates, so the thing you can load more. All right, if you max that out, you can put 10 kilo plates. This is now 40 kilo dumbbell, and you have plenty of room to add more. And then, if you want to add even more, you can put 20 kilo plates. This is 82 kilo dumbbell. Here, 80 kilos. And it's just this tiny profile, and plenty of room. So, pretty much if you just change the weight, you stick your plates, you can go pretty heavy with this. Which is not the case with the other types of adjustable dumbbells. They do not allow this kind of freedom, in many regards. Alright, another benefit of having the spin-lock dumbbell is that if you happen to have already this kind of plates, or this kind of plates, 20 or 10 or 5 kilo plates from your straight bar, which you already have, you can just use them in the spin-lock dumbbells. So basically you do not have to buy new weights, because you can use the same weights. And this works both ways. If you first buy the spin-lock dumbbells and weights for the spin-lock dumbbells, you do not have to buy new weights for your straight bar, because these go to the straight bar. Here we have this kind of bar, S-bar. These are the This is the same diameter rod than what this used. So you can just use the same weight you bought for this or this, or other way around, you can use the same weight you bought for this. And you don't have to buy new weights. With the other types of adjustable dumbbells, the issue can be that the plates are not interchangeable. You cannot use them in other types of bars. But I think it's ideal, in my opinion, these 30mm rod bars. Because all your plates are 30mm, and all your bars are 30mm. So basically, all your weights which fit every bar, which allow lots of freedom. And of course, the same is true with the straight bar. You can just buy this kind of long 30mm straight bar, which is also 30mm. It accepts 30mm plates. So you can use this all weights on this, if you bought these weights for the dumbbells, and if you bought the weights for the straight bar, you can use the same weights on the dumbbells. So basically, you only are buying one set of weights. But if you buy some other types of accessible dumbbells, you are buying your weights two times. You buy them for the dumbbells, and then you have to buy new set of weights for the straight bar. Whatever straight bar you are buying, which can get pretty expensive, since you are buying two times the weights. And with the other types of dumbbells, the weights can be pretty much more expensive than with the spin-lock dumbbells.
By the way, when I'm talking about spin-lock dumbbells, I'm not just talking about the 30mm spin-lock dumbbells and the bars. Because you can also buy the 50mm spin-lock dumbbells, which are compatible with the regular weights, 50mm weights, which go to the normal kind of bar. So you could have a home gym which has these normal bars and the normal plates, which are 50mm. The hole in the weights is 50mm, and they are, you could have these spin-lock dumbbells which takes these 50mm plates directly. So everything I'm saying in the video is also true if you choose to go with this kind of set of the regular type of hole size which is in the gym. So even though I have a gym, home gym, that uses these 30mm bars and spin-lock dumbbells, it doesn't mean I am claiming that this kind of setup wouldn't be good. Like, I'm just talking about spin-lock dumbbells in general, not just the 30mm spin-lock dumbbells. Alright?
Alright, little trick. If you happen to have plates with two types of plates, one which has the diameter is thicker, like, so I have these dumbbells now here, for example. Here, this one, on this one, all the plates are the same diameter. But with this one, the inner plate is a little bit thicker, a little bit bigger diameter. What it does, it creates space between these other plates, which then, if you are changing the weights, it makes changing the weights easier. Because if you are changing weights on this, when you are doing this, the weights kind of are dragging on the surface, which you are changing them. Which in some surfaces, it can stick to it, and it can make this hard to push it in or hard to pull it out. Since it's dragging on this surface. But with this kind of setup, it makes the changing the weights kind of easier, since these weights do not touch the surface at all. So if you are changing them, you just can freely change them and push them on. Like, the bar is levitating here. There is space here under the weights, since the inner plate is a little bit greater diameter than these outer side plates, even though it is the same weight. And of course, you could just do the same with, let's just putting here a bigger plate altogether. Like, if these are 2.5 kilo plates, you can just use 5 kilogram plate here, or 10 kilogram plate, and just use so that it would be kind of higher, so it makes easier to change this. All right. A trick here the dumbbell rack for these spin lock dumbbells. It can be pretty simple. Okay, here I have this like plywood plate, and other side of that plywood plate which has had screwed on two boards like so, and on the other side it just has one board here. And the idea behind this is that the board here on this side, it makes this tilt. So its idea about it is that when it tilts, the weights roll on it on this other direction, and these boards they catch the plates like so, and then like so. So now the weights are not rolling around, they will all always go to that position. So it's pretty simple dumbbell rack, and you can just change your weights here. I also recommend that you change your weights on some elevated surface, like a table, like you have some kind of place where you have these dumbbells, but you are not doing it on the floor, since it's very tiring, exhausting, and not very nice position to be changing plates. So you want to change them on the table. And you can just have your plates here, like next to this set. If this is your place, then you just gonna have different piles here of different plates. Here can be your one size, there is the bigger, and then here can be another pile of even bigger plates. And you can take them and put it on. It's super convenient. It's not a hassle at all. Because you wanna add a plate here, add a plate here, and you put your spin lock on. Alright, little tip here. When you have these spin locks, which go here, you put them on so that the rubber is touching the weight plate. And some of you say that they don't go pretty tight if you just use your arm and tighten them like this. Which is true. It's not very tight. But if you rotate the weight this way, on the same direction you are rotating this, you just think that this would be these locks, which they kinda are, since the rubber locks these locks. It locks these spin locks on these plates, which makes them the lock spin together with the plate, like so, which tightens it. You are since using this plate as a lever to tighten it even more. So if you tighten this from these plates, you can get them pretty tight. You can actually get them super tight, like so. It's pretty tight now. Like, there is no way this ever comes loose during your some exercise. Like, you can be pretty... There, I got it cutting loose. Let's do another experiment. There. Okay, now you have your super tight dumbbell here. There. Like, this does not come loose. Now the issue can be that how you open it. Since it's super tight, there is no way you tighten it, loosen it, like rotating these. So what you do is you rotate them. You tighten it then, right, rotating these like so. Which is the same direction as these spin locks tighten. You tighten it then like this. So what you open it is like this. The other side. And it, like so. This is how you open one side. The both sides do not open at the same time. Okay, then you got this side open. Now you still have this. And how you open it, this other side is, you take a plate. And you tap this lock. You tap it so that you are forcing it to rotate the direction by which it opens. This has these little wings. You are tapping in one of the wing with the blade so to open it. Like so. And then it's over. And this was super tight. I typically never put this so tight. But if you put them so tight, this is how you open it. And this is how you open any type of situation where it's too tight for you to open it like other way. Also, one trick is that to open this is that you can grab this instead of this. You grab this and this. And you turn this, like so. Okay? If I have only this side closed. The way you open it is, if it's not super tight, you can just take this, since this lock, with friction, it is moving together with these plates, since there is the rubber ring. The rubber ring makes this lock move together with these plates. So you can open this lock by rotating these plates. So, what you do is you hold this bar, and you rotate these plates, like so, and it opens. So you did not have to touch this lock, which is hard to grab, since it has a small profile. So again, if you have, let's put it tight here, somewhat tight. This is good tightness still. There is no problem with using this kind of tightness. So, you do not have to try to open it like this. It's super hard. But how you open it is holding these plates and then rotating this handle, like so. You get much more power on it. And of course it works if both sides are closed too. If the both sides are just moderately tightened, like so, you just do the opposite direction, like so. Now this side opened. This side didn't. You grab these thumb plates and you rotate it this so that it opens. There. And then if it's too tight to open like that, you use this method. You just tap this like I don't know. The point is that you tap this so that it spins. You are tapping this so that it would do this. You don't just hit it here, but you are tapping it so that it would spin. Alright?
Alright, if it's possible, I recommend that you buy two pairs of these spin lock dumbbells, because it makes changing the weight pretty much easier. Since, like I have here, these dumbbells I use to go from 5 kilos to 20 kilos. And these dumbbells I use to go from 20 kilos upward. So I never have to change too much weight. Because for example, I have like 30 kilos here on these dumbbells. And on these dumbbells I have 20 kilos. So if I like would like to do a drop set or whatever, and go from these 30 kilos to 20 kilos, I just grab this. And if I want to go from 30 kilos to like 15 kilos, I just take one plate off here. I do not have to like take these whole plates off and then put another plate here. It's a lot simpler. Have them like this. Or if I want to pick 10 kilos here, I just take these two plates off from these dumbbells. And not from these. So these are just for big weights and these are for small weights. Alright.